Okay, well, I'm sure you're all wondering what this is about, considering you're reading the title and that's why you're here. Or you're a subscriber and you just are so bored that you decided to watch my movie. But I have a 12-inch rail here, CMMG rail. And it's a good rail, you know. There's not a whole lot wrong with it, but what I don't like is that these spaces in here are too narrow, and they should have what they should have done is, like, you know, take this rib out, leave this out. Leave, out, leave, out, leave, and so forth. And that's what we're gonna do. I want to, you know, give this a little more openness, I guess. It gives me a chance, if I need to, adjust my gas block. It gives me a chance to get a wrench in there and, you know, just gives me a little bit more room. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna use a Dremel. We're gonna open it up. If we fuck this up, then your my next video is gonna be on a Fortis 12.5 or 12-inch switch. I've wanted one of those anyway. But I've got this rail. It does its job. You know, I just thought, well, I'll modify it. Now, once I modify it, you know, if it comes out real, everything's real good. Instead of a switch video, our next video is going to be hydro dipping my complete gun. So let's go from there. Okay, hopefully you can hear me, but I took some tape and I marked every other one, top and bottom. And basically, what this does is it gives you like a visual to, you know, kind of see if I even like this to begin with. You just have to imagine every other one kind of gone, you know, and you're gonna have this big box. And so if you, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the tape off and I'm going to just mark it with a pencil so that I, you know, don't accidentally take the wrong one. And then I'm going to get into this. I'll cut like a few out. And what we're going to use is just a Dremel. And these cut-off wheels, I don't know if you can see them here, but it looks like you might have to grind these down. Run your Dremel and run a grinder and just pretend like you're grinding the other stone and make the diameter a little smaller so it'll poke through. So let me get into that and then I'll come back on. Okay, here's my rail all done. You can see just how much more area is open for cooling, adjusting my gas block if I need to, without taking the handguard off. You can see the spots where I cleaned up the little remnants of the tabs. And then on the bottom, hard to see because I did right in there. But the rail aesthetically just looks so much better. I don't know why they didn't do this to begin with. I can guarantee you that taking out every other tab did not affect structural integrity. So now the only thing left to do is to just blacken these little sections. I have strongly considered either multicam hydro dip or stencils and Krylon multicam, but I'm just not sure. It seems like every time I camo something, I eventually want to go back to black for that menacing look, that evil black rifle look. But I just wanted to sort of let you see that. That's really nice. Alrighty, well, if I end up camo in this or whatever, I'll let you know. As far as just painting them black, I don't know. I thought about using gloss nail polish, but that would, maybe not work so well. I believe there's a Birchwood Casey's stuff called Aluma Black, and I thought about doing that. Just take a Q-tip and chemically blacken them. Or hell, maybe you could do it with a Sharpie. I don't know. But I'll figure something out and we'll catch you in the next video.